Hello everyone and welcome back. In today's video, I'm going to give you a quick guide and some tips from my own experience on how you can get tickets to see Idol Lives in Japan. And even though this mostly comes from an underground or Chika Idol Live experience, it pretty universally applies to any band that plays a similar size venue in an underground bar or something like that. So first let's talk about planning. Most groups usually don't announce their lives until maybe about 1 month in advance is when you'll start to see most of them. Though sometimes you'll get some further out in advance, but these are usually for special occasions such as a one-man live or an anniversary live or something like that. And for myself, I've even had a few experiences where lives are announced with as little as 1 day or 2 days notice before it actually happens. So let's look at some information real quick. So this here is a spreadsheet that I put over that is over the course of my 6 trips to Japan so far, and it realistically covers maybe about 3 months total. But as you can see here, most of the lives for the groups that I see happen in Shibuya and Shinjuku, and chances are this will apply for you as well, as it seems most of the groups that people know about are usually from Tokyo, but you also have groups based in other prefectures as well, such as Osaka, Nagoya, Kyoto, etc., etc. So the best way to track any of these lives is actually through Twitter, and Twitter will always be your best resource for information. There are some websites, but Twitter is where you'll always get the latest updates. So let's quickly look at some information for a live that's going on. So here on the screen right now, we're looking at a show for Nomark that takes place on August 12th at Shibuya Milky Way. And they've got quite a few groups here. And these are called Taibons, and that's usually what you'll experience. Taking a quick look at my notes here. Okay, so when we look at this tweet here, there's a lot of information to unpack. So first, let's address this plus 1D right here. And what this means is this is a drink fee, and it's a mandatory drink fee that almost all live houses charge. I've never seen it be lower than 500 yen, and it seems that quite a few venues recently have actually increased this to 600 yen, and it's unavoidable. You have to pay it no matter which live house you're going to, pretty much. And if you ever see a live that's actually free, which I know a group that does this weekly, then they'll actually charge you for 2 drinks, but it's pretty uncommon to see at a show like this that has an admission cost. So let's talk about some benefits of actually reserving. So for a lot of these lives, you don't actually need to purchase a ticket in advance. All you have to do is reserve with the group. And this comes with many benefits. The most obvious usually is just that it basically saves you the drink fee. So this 2,500 here is the advance price if you reserve with the group. And then the 3,000 yen is if you just show up on the day without a reservation. And let's go ahead and translate this real quick so we can see that. So advance price, 25, day, 3,000. So that's your first benefit. And then right here is the second benefit to reserving. And some groups will sometimes offer incentives or freebies if you reserve with them. So in this case, they're offering you a 10-second video. Some other freebies sometimes are you get a group shot with a you get a group shot on your phone, or maybe with a member on your phone. Or maybe you'll get a group checky for reserving with them. It just varies from group to group, and not all of them offer, but quite a few do. So that covers the benefits of reserving, but let's talk about how to actually reserve. So for this particular live here, they have this Google form that I have the link already open. So we go here. And I also highly recommend that whenever you're dealing with any of this, especially if you understand no Japanese, that you use Chrome, because Chrome has this nifty little auto-translate feature in the right-click menu. So we can do that. So if we want to go to the live on August 12th, then we just select that, and then we type in our name, how many tickets we want, and our email address, and they'll send us a form. Another method that some groups use, but not a lot, is they will actually have reservations through ticket.net. So this is actually for another show that Nomark is at. So if we wanted to reserve for this particular show, then we would select the 2500 ticket button here. And again, another reason for using the translate. So we can do continue without registering. And then we just fill out basically the same information. Our name, email address, how many tickets you want. And then you hit reserve and you'll get an email along with a ticket number. And I'll go a little bit more into detail about what that ticket number represents later. But let's go back to Nomark's tweet. I believe we've got all the information from this particular tweet that we can get. Except for the third way that you can reserve, and a lot of groups use this method as well, is you can actually just reply directly to the show tweet for that you want to go to, and you can just type something in like Yoyaku, which means reservation, one ticket for, and then your name. And they'll usually put you on the list there for the reservation just by replying to that tweet. So let's look at that other show that Nomark is at again really quick. So this is a timetable for a show that they're on. And even though we see here that the doors open at 12 and that it starts at 12:30, what I've seen quite often that people do is they actually won't show up to a show like this, which is an all-day show, until just about when the time that the group that they like comes on. So if I was interested in Nomark, then I could very easily show up at 16:45 and have no issue seeing them. But in general, if this was a smaller show like this first one that we were looking at that only has seven groups, most people still won't show up for this show until maybe 5 minutes, 10 minutes maximum before the door open time, because a lot of these shows just don't sell out. It's pretty rare for any of these shows to sell out. But back to the timetable that we were looking at. So as I said, a lot of people won't show up until a few minutes before the group that they particular that comes on. But what you'll see when you're at one of these shows commonly happen is between groups you'll see the fans shift around from the front to the back. And this is pretty common concert etiquette to allow those who are a fan of that group coming up to get to the front half of the venue, where those who don't really care and want to play on their phones shift more to the back of the venue. And most fans tend to do this. There are some groups that have a few fans that just hog the rail for the entire show, but that's more rare than anything. So an example for that is, if I was into this group, Oyasumi Seikai right here, then the fans would have no problem letting me into the front half, and then after Oyasumi Seikai is off, if I'm not interested in any other groups for a while, then I would just move to the back and then let those fans of 81 Moment and Tokyo Flamingo, etc., up to the front for them to see their groups if they like. And also, when you arrive, when you go to pay at the desk to whoever the door person is, whether you have a reservation for the group or not, they will always ask you for the group name. And part of this is they use this information to decide how they divide up the money for each group playing on a show for that day. Also, looking at this timetable here, the times on the right-hand side here are actually the times for the merchandise or Bupon. This group here, Sugar Planet, and everyone after that, they all go on about 5 minutes after their set ends, and the letter determines what portion of the venue they'll be in, because this is a large venue. And this is how they do that, but most commonly, especially on a show like the small one, all the groups will have Shuengo Bupon, like these last five here on this example, and Shuengo Bupon just means that they'll do all their merchandise and Bupon sales after the last set. The merchandise includes t-shirts, CDs, keychains, anything else they come up with. The most popular usually tends to be two-shot checkies, which are a Polaroid with you and one of the members. And these usually cost 1,000 yen. There's some groups have gone up to 1,500 yen. And most of the time, but not all the time, the checkie will come with a signature from the idol that you decide to get the picture with, and also 30 seconds to a minute talk time. Looking at my notes again here. So when it comes to the time to buy merchandise and do all of this, you'll usually see a sign similar to this one right here for each group. So each group will have their name on the sign, and then they'll have something like these three kanji here that say, well, this is the end of the line. And how each group goes completely about how they do this really varies by them and also by the size offered by the venue. So some groups will only have one line for merchandise and checkie. Some groups will separate their merchandise line from their checkie line, and some groups will also further separate their checkie line so that each member of the group has their own checkie line. And how exactly all this works out, you'll just have to figure out at the venue as it's going on, because it will vary show to show with how many groups are there and also the size of the venue. So alternatively to shows that you pay for, there are also often store events which are free. So we can look at Melon Batake here, who have free store events. So each of these store events is free, though in some cases, if the group is a larger group that they know it's going to be really packed and really full in the store, then they will actually require you to buy a CD in advance to get a ticket that basically secures your place in the actual event area. So one example is I went to a Bish store event one time, and I didn't reserve a ticket in advance. So even though I could still be in the store, the event area was so packed that without the ticket, I was not able to get in there. So if I had that ticket, then I would have been assured a spot in the event area to actually see them up closer, rather than off from the way back or on the very side. But store events are typically run as you buy so many CDs, and each CD gets you minimum one ticket that you can put towards different rewards and benefits. And if it's a full album release, that costs a little bit more. So these are just singles right here for 1,000 yen each. But if it's maybe a full album that costs 3,000, then you might get 2 or 3 tickets for it. It will all just depend on the group, and it's just information that you'll have to look up from the details that they release. So here's an example of some of the benefits that they'll offer. I can't read all of this, so I'll just read off the bits that I can really quick. So the numbers here are just the number of CDs that you buy. So 1 CD, 2 CD, 3 CD, etc., etc. So for 1 CD, your benefit is you get a two-shot picture on your phone. I believe this is Shame, which means a picture on your phone. And then there's some other bonuses that you get that I'm not exactly sure what they are. This is a stamp of some sort, but I don't know exactly what that is. So for 2 copies, you get a two-shot checky plus the stamp, and then this is Melon Kuji. Kuji means random, and I assume this is a one count of whatever they're offering up for random. And then so for 3, 4, 5, and 10 pieces, they're all basically the same. There is a significant difference between 3 pieces and 4 pieces here, though. For 3 pieces, you get a group checky, but the signed nashi means that they will not sign it. And then for the 4 pieces, you get the kakomi checky or group checky that's signed Adi, and this means with signature. And then the differences then between 4, 5, and 10 are just in the number of the stamps that you get and the number of whatever this random item is. And to find where these store events are happening, you can just track the group's Twitter. They'll usually post them on there. But if you want to try looking ahead a little bit, then both Tower Records and HMV actually have sites where you can look it up. So you can go to tower.jp/store/event to look up what events they offer. And again, an argument for the Chrome translation, so you can better see what store they're at, and then also whether they're doing benefits or just a handshake. So usually if it says benefits or privilege party, then that would indicate that they have like checkies or other bonuses like that. And then for HMV, you can actually get in pure English version. So you can go to hmv.co.jp/en/store/event, and that'll be all of their listings there. So up till now, we've talked all about events that you don't actually need tickets or reservations for. But what about those instances when you do need a ticket? Well, this will mostly apply to any larger groups that you've probably heard about, such as any of the WAC groups like Bish, Gang Parade, BIS, and Empire, and then other groups that seem to do regular tours too. So on the rock side, you have more like Bandmade, maybe Bratz, some Code of Memento groups maybe you would want to buy in advance for, but every time I have for them, I've always had a low number. So in the end, it kind of didn't really matter. But for any group that seems large like that, they have a large following, so like Passcode is another good example, then you would want to buy the ticket in advance. However, there are some restrictions and limits that foreigners really have to deal with. So the first limit being that the two major ticketing websites, ePlus and TicketPaya, they made some changes 2 years back or so that to make a new account with them, you have to have a Japanese phone number to verify your account. So we're all kind of fucked out of being able to do that. And the other limitation is lotteries. So I'm on Bish's website here for their new Hateful Kind tour. And so these tickets have already gone on sale. However, they've run multiple lotteries. And it's basically as it sounds. You put your name into a pool, and then they draw out names, and those people are then able to buy the tickets. And this is important if you decide to go with a proxy buying service, which I'll cover in a bit, because they'll add extra fees for any lottery applications. And it also plays a factor in another method that you can get tickets if you're already in Japan. So I want to explain a little bit how lotteries work. So looking at Bish as an example here. So all of these all of these right here are lotteries. And these are the dates that the lottery starts. So this first lottery started on the 4th, then the 6th, 16th, 23rd. So if you applied for any of these through a proxy service, then they would likely charge you an extra fee for there. But let's say you're in Japan and you're able to get a ticket through a FamilyPort machine, which, as I said, I'll cover in a little bit, then that would start, I believe, on July 31st and August 8th here. So anytime after those, you should be able to buy the ticket on your own if you're already within Japan. But talking about that proxy service, if you really want the ticket as early as possible and you already know for sure you're going to go, bridge.jpn is a service that a lot of people have used and seem to be pretty happy with it. So they will buy tickets for you and they will actually ship international, which I did not know before I filmed this video. And they sort of have a breakdown here that you can pause the video and read over really quick, but I also have an example from somebody on Reddit. So this Reddit user bought a ticket again for Bish, and the base price for his ticket was 4,800 yen just for the ticket itself. So what he ended up paying in fees was he paid an 838 yen fee for ticket system fee, and this is probably the fee for the lottery and maybe also to print the ticket out, because I do also have fees for printing the tickets. And then he also had a product handling fee. They originally quoted him 1,800 yen, but again, this may be like the lottery part of the lottery cost. So they took 500 yen off, only, and his fee ended up being 1,300. So on top of the 4,800, he paid another about 2,100 for the ticket. And that's really not bad, because the one time that I used a proxy service that they are defunct now, I actually ended up paying about double for it. So this is actually a pretty good deal for that. But let's say you're already in Japan and you do want to get a ticket for, say, Kodama Mental or something like that, then you can actually use some FamilyPort machines that are located in FamilyMart convenience stores. And what this is this is actually a guide that I put together on how you can do that, as there is some Japanese required and Japanese reading. And I just kind of figured this out through trial and error. So I'll link this guide in the video description for you guys to follow along with if you need to, or just to save, or whatever you want to do with it. And this brings me to... And so when you do need a ticket, there's always going to be a number on the ticket. And what this number is this number actually determines when you enter. So it'll usually be on the side where they rip off the stub. And then it'll also be sort of on the bottom right corner. If you could see the rest of the ticket, it would be sort of in this bottom right corner right here. And they use this number, as I said, to determine what order you enter into the venue. And when they call it, and this also applies for anything that is reserved through this website, Tiget.net. Tiget.net also applies numbers to all of their reservations, and they'll use the same ticket number method for entry to any of those lives reserved through here. And the ticket is also another decent source to find some lives in general. But when they call these numbers out, depending on the size of the venue, they may start in singles. So you really, really need to brush up on your Japanese numbering, unless you have a friend there who can help you out, with it. So if it's a smaller live, then they might start by singles. And then eventually at some point, then they might start going by groups. So they'll start calling Ichiban, Nibon, Sanbon, which is ticket 1, ticket 2, ticket 3. And then after so long, they might start going up to groups such as Nijubon, Sanjubon, Yonjubon, which is anybody lower than... anybody lower than that ticket number. No, I'm sorry, I have that wrong. Anybody who has, so for Nijubon, anyone who has 20 to 29 goes in, and then Sanjubon, anybody who has 30 to 39 go in, and for Yonjubon, anyone who has 40 to 49 go in. And they may even up the grouping to 20s. So then they might do Nijubon, Yonjubon, Rokujubon, etc., etc. So that would be anybody who has 21 to 39, 41 to 59, 61 to 79, etc., etc., and keep going like that. And they'll usually stop calling numbers until people stop coming up with whatever number, and then they'll, from there, they'll just go general entry if there's any general admission spots available. And I believe that's all I have for this video. So if you have any further questions or comments or your own tips, please leave them in the comments. And if you have any questions, then I'll try my best to answer them if I know. And you know, this is pretty universal no matter where you go in the country and no matter what genre for the most part, because yeah, so I hope you found this video helpful, and have a good day.